Hi everyone, this is Pooja Khandevarad Bhonve as Assistant Professor of Department of Artificial Intelligence and Data Science in ASSMS IOIT. So in this session we see the DDA algorithm, DDA circle drawing algorithm. In that we have our different three algorithms, that is vector generations of algorithm, after that Brezhnev's algorithm and midpoint algorithm. So in that we see the second algorithm, that is Brezhnev's circle drawing algorithm. So we will continue for this. So all of you know the equations of a circle. So we know that the equation of the circle, that is x square plus y square equal to r square, where x is nothing but the x and y is nothing but the origin coordinate of a x and y, and here r is nothing but the radius of the circle. So in that the circle is by using Brezhnev's circle drawing algorithm, the circle is divided into quadrants, that is by using the point property of symmetry. So here is the octant will be formed in the whenever you drawing the circle, that is quadrant 1, quadrant 2, quadrant 2, quadrant 3 and quadrant 4. So in that, by using the its position, the x and y coordinate will be changed. So xy first octant same like x, y and x, that is second octant same like other, that is octant hand generated by using property of symmetry. So now we will discuss the Brezhnev circle drawing algorithm. So in that, thus given that the center point of the radius of a circle, Brezhnev circle drawing algorithm attempts to generate the points of an one octant. So that is the different points will be generated for the each and every octant. So the points of other octants are generated using the 8 symmetry of property that we have already discussed in the before slide. So we will discuss now the Brezhnev circle drawing algorithm. So the procedure related to Brezhnev circle drawing algorithm is like that. So we require the first, that is center point of the circle, that is x0 and the y0. After that we require the radius of the circle that we have mentioned, that r. After that, now we will see the point generation using the Brezhnev circle drawing algorithm, how it will be evolved by using these steps. So suppose firstly we have to assign the starting coordinates, that is x0 and y0, as x0 will be a 0 and y0 will be the radius of that particular circles for drawing. And this is the first steps, that is for assigning the starting coordinate, that is x0 will be a 0, that is origin center of the circle, and y0 will be the radius of that circle. So now we have to second step, that is we have to calculate the initial decision parameter, that is we can say we have discussed here p0. So we for that calculation we require p0 equal to, there is a formula, that is p0 equal to 3 minus 2 into r. So in that so we will get the initial decision parameter p0. So now next steps will be suppose the current position will be xk, and then next point will be the xk plus 1. Suppose we have got the first point. Now we have to go from this. Now next will be this. So it will be goes on. So first point will be xk and yk. So next point will be xk plus 1, yk plus 1, xk plus 2, yk plus 2, and so on. So this is how the next point of the first octant, depending on the value of decision parameter pk, we will calculate. Now next there is a two cases arrived for finding out the pk, that is parameter decision or the decision parameter. So we will follow the two cases for the finding out the decision parameter. So if case number 1, that is pk is greater than of 0, then we have to follow this, apply this formula, that is xk plus 1, that is next coordinate of x equal to, we have to add that coordinate, that is xk plus 1, and same for the yk plus 1 equal to, as it is your yk. So your generated coordinates will be, that is of decision parameter, next decision parameter will be pk plus 1 equal to pk plus 4 xk plus 1 plus 6. So this is the first case for calculating the your next value of x and y as well as decision parameter. If the pk is greater than 0, if pk is less than or equal to 0, then so this is the second condition. We have to calculate xk plus 1 equal to xk plus 1, that is next coordinate, and yk plus 1 equal to, we have to minus 1 into the your related to y coordinate, that is yk minus 1, and related to your decision parameter, that is pk plus 1 equal to your first parameter, decision parameter, that is pk plus 4x into xk minus of yk plus 1 plus 10. So this is the case 2, when you have to finding out, that is pk is less than or equal to 0. So these are the two cases related to finding out the decision parameter. So this is how calculations of decision parameter will be done. Now we will come to the steps number 4. So if the given center point is x0, y0 is not a 0, 0, then we have to plot the following point, that is x plot equal to xc plus x0 and y plot equal to yc and y0. So here xc and yc will denote the current value of x and y coordinate. So this is how the plotting will be done. Now steps number 5, if or keep repeating steps 3 and 4 until you can get x plot is equal to or greater than equal to or greater than of y plot, that is we getting the same value of x plot and y plot. We have to continue for the step number 3 and step number 4. So the next steps will be 6. So after the step 5, generates all the points of a one octant to find. So this is how the all the points of a one octant has been generated. So repeat all these steps to generate all the points of a particular one octant in the step 6. So this is how the algorithm will be work on that. Firstly, we have to finding out the given that center of circle, after that radius of the circle. Next, we will be have to finding out the point generation by using Bresnahan circle algorithm. In that step number 1 will be, we have to assign the initial coordinate x0 and y0 will be 0 and r. After that, step number 2, we have to calculate the initial decision parameter, that is p0 equal to 3 minus 2 into r. Next, on the steps 3, we have to finding out the current position, that is xk and yk, and the next current position will be yk, xk plus 1 and yk plus 1. In that, next point of the first octant, depending on the value of decision parameter pk, for finding out that, we have to two cases, that if case number 1, pk is greater than or 0, and case number 2 will be pk is less than or equal to 0. So after this step number 4, we have to finding out the center point, that is x0, y0 is not be a 0, 0. Then so if you have to check this condition, then we have to plot the point, that is x plot equal to xc y0 and y plot equal to yc plus y0. Here xc and yc will be denote the current value of x and the y coordinate. Next, we have to keep repeating all the steps of 3 and 4 until we can get x plot equal to a greater than a y plot. And then next steps will be, steps 5 will be generates all the points of a one octant. So this is how the working of your Bresnahan's circle drawing algorithm. So if we to find out the other 7 octants, follow the 8 symmetry property of a circle. This is depicted by the we have seen in this figure. So now so this is how the working of Bresnahan circle drawing algorithm. So we can now we will go to the advantages and disadvantages of Bresnahan circle drawing algorithm. That is the entire algorithm. Advantages is the entire algorithm is based on the simple equation, that is x square and y square equal to r square. It is easy to implement. So these are the advantages related to Bresnahan circle drawing algorithm. One more thing is disadvantages. So like midpoint algorithm, the accuracy of generating the point is an issue in this algorithm. So this is the disadvantages. Next will be this algorithm suffers when used to generate the complex and high graphical images. So when you have to generate a complex and high graphical images, your algorithm suffers more complicated. After that, there is no significant of enhancement with respect to the performance. So this is the advantages related to Brazenham circle, disadvantages related to Brazenham circle drawing algorithm. So so in that we have see the so thank you.